Learning more about childhood trauma and ACEs, we could understand more of the root cause of many of the problems in our community. Heart disease, addiction, depression, even crime and teen pregnancy are often symptoms of something else. A lot of it goes back to trauma, abuse, suffered in childhood.
Before kami maglaro against Azzurri Girls, emotional yung team dahil sa mga tampuhan, gano'n. Dumating sa point na nag-iyakan kami, gano'n.
On paper, we should have beaten Azzurri Girls, but you don't play anything on paper.
Azzurri Girls played well as a team, we didn't that day.
Sometimes there were flashes of brilliance. Other times, they were affected by their emotions off the field. It finished 2-2, and in this league, any draw goes to golden goal and then penalties. The old MLS-style penalties, too. There's a good quote about coaching that says, you don't coach a sport, you coach a player. You'll have days like this where the girls don't play to their full potential, especially with where they're coming from.
We know that severe childhood trauma can reduce your life expectancy by nearly 20 years.
One of the fascinating parts was understanding exactly how childhood trauma affects our bodies and minds.
Yung usual response natin kapag may stress is either flight or fight. Maganda yan sa mga emergency situation kasi pinapalakas ka niya if you have to fight back and pinapabilis ka niya kapag kailangan mo tumakbo. Pero paano kung hindi tayo pwedeng lumaban and hindi tayo pwedeng tumakbo? Kasi yung problema nasa loob ng bahay o nasa loob ng school.
Then we often react with the third stress response, freeze. When the stress response is constantly on, we're always in high alert. Your immune system gets weaker because it doesn't have enough energy to function properly. So you get sicker faster. And when you're stuck in that situation, in the long run, that's what can create feelings that lead to depression, that lead to addiction.
Oh, mahirap yung mga ganitong problema. Minsan may feeling ka na parang wala na siyang pag-asa. Pero alam ko na may paraan. Kasi ako mismo naranasan ko, ako mismo naka-experience na galing ako sa ganong punto ng buhay ko pero naiangat ko yung sarili ko. Kaya naniniwala ako may paraan. Yung pinakakailangan ng mga bata, emotional support talaga na manggagaling sa mga tao sa paligid nila, yung maniniwala na kaya nila.
Research calls it a buffering adult, having someone who's always there for you. You don't have to be perfect, you don't have to solve all their problems, you just have to show you care.
Once you have that person, reversing childhood trauma, research shows, comes down to 6 areas.
Dati dito kami natutulog. Sampu kami, nagsisiksika kami dito sa maliit na bahay. Tapos sa sobrang dami namin, nakakagat na kami ng mga lamok, ganun.
Excited ako lumipat doon sa dorm kasi may sarili ng kama, makakumpleto na yung tulog ko.
Sa kitchen tour natin. Andito po ngayon si Nanay.
Nay, say hi!
Fresh tofu and sitaw.
Tapos, ito yung naman ng ref namin, yan. Kung mapapansin nyo, puro gulay kasi vegetarian kami rito. Healthy living, mga bibi.
Nung wala pa akong exercise, mabilis lang ako mapagod. Tapos, nakakatamad kumilos.
Ngayon, nalaman ko na mas okay pala kapag may exercise. Hindi na ako madaling mapagod. Tapos, marami na din akong energy para mag-training.
A lot of this is common sense, but it's not common action. And especially when you live in poverty, it's very difficult to find a good place to sleep. It's very difficult to find healthy food. It's difficult to have a space to play. The good news is that you can do these things however you want. It doesn't matter if your bedtime is 7 o'clock or 10 o'clock. Eat the fresh fruits, veggies, the whole foods that you like. Play football or basketball, dance, anything. What matters most is that you do it. That routine helps to regulate our bodies and minds. It begins to balance our hormones. We feel happier and healthier because it starts the healing process. It gives us a chance to get to the deeper levels. The girls were much better here. They pushed the other side much more, and they played together as a team. The result was the same. It went to penalties, but you don't mind the result so much when you see the team growing, learning, getting better every week. Because you know the results will come later on and off the pitch.
Pwede malungkot tayo na saglit, tapos balik natin sa improvement natin. Last week, nainis ako kasi yung nag-training natin hindi pakita. Ngayon, mas mabuti. So kahit talo, mas mabuti compared to last week. Well done. That's 1, 2, 3!
The really great thing is that when these kids get that love, get that support, that care, they start giving it to others too.
The issue of childhood trauma sounds so heavy, and it is. But now we know that the problem isn't you, it's what happened to you. With good sleep, healthy food, regular exercise, we give ourselves a chance. We can now look at the final three parts: social support, mindfulness, mental health. This is how we can reverse childhood trauma, not only for us, but for the next generation too.
Interviewin natin si Coach Roy.
Hello, Melanie's Vlog.
Ano maganda sa laro, Coach? Ako. Coach, ano ba yung sabi mo sa laro ngayon kumpara dun sa mga nakalaban natin?
Sorry, what?
English. What did you say to play or ano? Ano mo sabi mo? Sabi mo, Coach! Coach, thank you na lang, Coach! I love you!
You're welcome na lang.
Guys, alam nyo, balu talaga yung coach ko. Balu talaga yung kaya ganun yun, guys.